The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. Taken from the Gospel according to Luke. And here we hear how Mary, once she received the annunciation from the angel, she sets herself in motion. She travels in haste to greet her cousin Elizabeth. That is your mission, to set yourselves in motion, that you may stand and go out to the world and share the love, the good news of God with others.
For now, the Lord has spoken, who formed me as his servant from the womb, that Jacob may be brought back to him and Israel gathered to him. And I made it glorious in the sight of the Lord, and my God is now my strength. It is too little, he says, for you to be my servant, to raise up the tribes of Israel, the tribes of Jacob, and restore the survivors of Israel. I will make you a light to the nations, that my salvation may reach to the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful song.
We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
Know that the Lord is God. He made us. His we are. His people, the flock he tends.
We are.
And his faithfulness to all generations.
We are his people, the sheep of his flock.
Let us love one another, because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might have life through him, and this is love. Not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also must love one another. No one has ever seen God. Yet, if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. This is how we know that we remain in him and he in us, that he has given us of his Spirit. Moreover, we have seen and testified that the Father sent his Son as Savior of the world. Whoever acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God remains in him and he in God. We have come to know and to believe in the love of God has for us. God is love, and whoever remains in love remains in God and God in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever. Mary remained with her about 3 months and then returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord. Wonderful to see all the blessings you have received. The blessing of your life, the blessing of your faith, the blessing of your family, the blessing of your friends. And that is why it is good that today you come to the giver of every blessing, of every good gift, to the Lord himself, to say thank you. But also today, we come with you to pray for you, that you may continue to live your life of faith, because your life is changing, because you're no longer children, you're becoming women, and that implies huge responsibilities in life, your family, and many other things, that you always turn to the Lord, that you always do these things according to the Lord's will, saying, Lord, what do you want? What do you need from me as a Christian woman that I may continue to grow in your love? And that is why today we also read from Scripture. We read the first reading. It is taken from a book from the Old Testament, from a prophet, the prophet Isaiah. And the Lord speaks to him because he was afraid. I don't know what to do. And the Lord tells him, I called you from your mother's womb. Even before you were born, I know your name. And then, this is the Old Testament. The Lord says something very beautiful. I made you a sharp-edged sword. Having a sword at that time was very important because that's the only way people could protect themselves. So the Lord tells Isaiah, I have made out of you something very special, something very valuable. Jaslyne, Angelica, the Lord has made something very, very valuable out of you too. And that will begin to show as you continue to grow and mature in your life. With the responsorial song, we repeat it. We are his people, the sheep, members of his flock, of his group. Please, never forget that you are the sheep of the Lord. The Lord, and as you make your decisions in life, never be afraid to remember that you are Christian women, that you belong to the Lord since the day of your baptism. In the second reading, this is taken from the New Testament, the Apostle John tells us that God is love. And that is our mission in life, that we share that love with others. And that is what you need to find out when you make those decisions in life. How can I better serve? What am I going to study? Whatever helps me love others better. What work will I take? Whatever work helps you love others better, to reflect the love of God, so that everything we do is done with love. Who shall I date? Who shall I marry eventually down the road? Whomever you are able to express that love to. So this is our project. This is what we are made for. So we come to the gospel, taken from the gospel according to Luke. And here we hear how Mary, once she received the annunciation from the angel, she sets herself in motion. She travels in haste to greet her cousin, Elizabeth. That is your mission, to set yourselves in motion, that you may stand and go out to the world and share the love, the good news of God with others. This is our mission. This is your mission. Remember, since even before you were born, the Lord knew you and loved you and has kept you close to his heart. So always remember that it is with the Lord you can be the best person possible. Now, a moment, I will invite you to renew your baptismal promises. And those promises are basically two. The first promise, we promise to reject anything that pulls us away from God, anything that divides our heart. And the second promise, is believing in God, making Him, only Him, the center of our life. And one day, your parents and your godparents, when you were brought to church to be baptized, they made these promises in your name. Now you're able to renew them with joy by yourself, telling the Lord, "Yes, Lord, we believe. We want to stay away from anything that harms us, anything that would harm others, anything that would not help us grow as your children. We accept you as our only Lord and Savior. And with this, I will give you a special blessing today, so that you may always continue to live your lives as Christian women. We rejoice with you today, and we invite you to rejoice as well as we all pray together for you. May the Lord bless you abundantly, and always remember the huge blessing you have received in your family. After the Lord, always look for your family for guidance, for advice, for backup. They're always going to be there for you, loving you more than anybody else, so that you may continue to grow and fulfill your dreams. There's so many possibilities in life, but you have to face one at a time. And with the help of God, with the help of your family, with the help of your friends, you will be able to achieve great things in life. That is why today we rejoice with you in this very special moment here in church, in which we lift our prayers to the Lord for you. Congratulations. Many, many blessings, and may you always rejoice in the Lord. Now I will invite you to renew your baptismal promise. Jess and Angelica, when you were little girls, your parents and godparents brought you to the baptismal waters to be initiated in the new life of our Savior Jesus Christ. At that moment, they made a profession of faith in your favor and in your name. The same faith now brings you before this altar. Therefore, the church now asks you to renew and confirm this same commitment of faith voluntarily and with conviction. I invite you to respond, "I do." Do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the daughters of God?
I do. I do.
Do you renounce the seduction of evil so that sin does not enslave you? Do you renounce Satan, father and author of sin?
I do.
Then I invite you to profess your faith. Do you believe in God, Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the only Son of our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered, was buried, rose from the dead, and is seated at the right hand? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of the body?
I do.
Then I invite you to pronounce then your act of thanksgiving. Would you please kneel?
Loving God, I thank you for the gift of life, for creating me in your image and likeness, and for calling me to be your daughter through baptism. Thank you for sending your Son Jesus to save me and your Holy Spirit to sanctify me. I will say yes to all that you love for me, in your goodness and love. With your grace, I commit myself to serve my brothers and sisters all my life. Mary, Mother of Jesus, and our Mother, I dedicate myself to you. Since you are my model of faith, help me to continue learning from you what I need to be. Help me to hear the word of God as you do, holding it in my heart and loving others, so that as I walk with Jesus in this life, I may worship Him with you and all.
Heavenly Father, we bless you because you have created all things for the good of men. We ask you to bless His Bibles, His religious articles, so that we can always count on your blessing and your protection through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you. Let us present our intentions, cares, and concerns to God through Jesus Christ, for our Holy Father Francis, for our Bishop Patrick, and all those who have dedicated their lives to the service of the people of God, so that they may faithfully follow their vocation. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayers. For the civil authorities to carry out their duties with justice and compassion for the good of all, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayers. For Jas and Angelica, who celebrate their birthday, that they may follow the path of Jesus with joy and generosity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayers. For the parents, godparents, grand and grandparents of Jas and Angelica, that they continue to enjoy the fruit of their love in their children, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayers. For our youth, especially for Angelica's and Jas's companions of faith, so that they may have the necessary strength to live according to the Christian principles, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the sick and poor in our community, so that they may feel God's love for them through those who have alleviated their needs, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayers. For all our personal intentions that are deep in our hearts, and for all those for whom we must pray, so that they receive the graces that they need, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayers. For our deceased relatives, so that they may enjoy the vision of God in heaven, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
God of love, we approach you with these requests that we offer you because we need you through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And now, brothers and sisters, with Jas and Angelica, let us pray to the Father as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Now, brothers and sisters, I will give communion to Jas and Angelica, so that you can always be reminded that Jesus is the food that we need for the journey of life. As they receive communion, I ask you to please remain standing. Once they have received communion, you may all be seated. So that they may grow in wisdom, knowledge, and grace always loving their family and being faithful to their friends, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Just now turn so that your face will go that way. Right there, right there.
First, I want to say thank you, God, for my health and this wonderful moment. This is a dream come true, and I am grateful to my parents for giving me life and for being my example every day. I promise them that I will improve in every aspect. I want to continue to have their support and their love. To my siblings for sharing so many beautiful things during these years, to all of you, my family, friends, to all guests for existing and attending. For me, it is really a pleasure to have your company on a day as special as this, since you are an important part of this stage that passes and another that begins. I will carry them in my mind and in my heart. I am very excited and very happy. The happiness I feel right now, I cannot describe through words, and I simply want to enjoy. And like y'all, I only want you to share my happiness with everything that has been prepared for my quinceañera. Since time goes fast and the good memories of the moments lived are left behind as well, again, I thank you all for having your company on a day as special and important as this. For me, I hope you have a great time and that y'all enjoy the celebration. I love you guys so much. Thank you.
I just want to say thank you all for coming to the blessing today. Your presence means so much to me, and I truly appreciate each and every one of you. I can't wait to see you all at the venue to celebrate this special day together. Lastly, I want to thank God for letting me be here today and for letting this special day happen.
Thank you. un aplauso fuerte. Ahora seguimos con The Last Bear. Los padrinos Jasper y Amo Fernando Guerrero.
Thank you.
Unos aplausos a los papás, Roberto y Ángel. Ahora sí, ¿quién va?
¿Dónde tus juguetes? Hoy tu mundo va a cambiar. Ya no los querrás usar.
Thank you.
Un aplauso fuerte.
Oh,
for being here with me on this special day. Your love and generosity mean so much to me, and I will always carry you in my heart. To my camaradas, thank you for being a part of this celebration and for making this day the moment. Your friendship and company are invaluable. Thank you for coming and sharing this moment with me. Your presence here means the world to me, and I am so grateful to have you in my life. I want to give a very special thank you to my stepdad, Robert, and mom for making this party possible. Your effort, love, and dedication have made this day unforgettable. I don't have enough words to express how grateful I am for everything you have done for me. Finally, I am grateful to be able to celebrate this party and to have so many loved ones around me. This is a day I will remember forever. Thanks to all of you. Thank you very much.
I want to thank God for having us here today and to everyone for coming out here near and far to celebrate mine and my sister's King together. From the bottom of my heart, I want to give a huge thank you to all my padrinos. You all hold a special part in my heart. I especially want to say thank you to my stepdad, Robert, for your sleepless long work hours, working 7 days a week. Without you, we wouldn't have this. So thank you for your sacrifice. Thank you for always surprising me at my school events, even if it cost you a 6-hour drive and making it 2 hours before my 8th grade promotion. I will hold your conditional love for us in my heart. Mom, thank you. Mom, thank you for putting up with me and Jaslyne disagreements and fits. All this could have been possible without you either, even though we can be pain. I know deep down you love us. I love you both for the advice you give us, for the support, and you always show up when we need you the most. Thank you to our cousins and stepbrother for being our chambelans. We couldn't have done this dances and day without you. To my sister Jaslyne, thank you for giving up your pizza and having a sweet 16 so we can both celebrate together. I know we can bump heads, but I promise I love you and look up to you. I'm happy to be here and sharing this special day together. Thank you.
But don't let anyone treat you as if you are not important.
Be an example to show the believers how they should live. Show them by what you say, by the way you live, by the way you love, by your faith, and by your life. I love you, my baby girls.
Good evening, and welcome. This is all AI, by the way. I'm Splint. It's been almost 10 years since I met Rachel and she said that it was going to be a package. She wasn't alone, it was two daughters. Didn't expect it to be this far, but I'm glad that we've made it this far. Seeing y'all grow up to the women, the young women that are becoming, the dreams that are set up to you, it makes me proud of that. Y'all have a great time. But I'm looking forward to being next to y'all for the rest, as far as I can make it. I don't know when. But we'll promise to be there beside you and we're glad to stay close to y'all and support y'all everywhere in your decisions. Even though we're going to be praying for someone. But thank you everybody for coming, the padrinos, for helping out. I know it's tough with how everything's going today. But from the bottom of our hearts, we appreciate everything that y'all did to help put all this together. Thank y'all.
So with that said, we want to lift our glasses for our daughter's health. Cheers.
Cheers.
what I'm talking about.